Hello everyone. In this video, we will discuss about various task management functions of MuCOS 2. You must have known various functions, that is OS task create, OS task delete, various semaphore task. So we will cover that task in one by one, that syntax part. So what is the learning outcomes for this? After completing this session, student will be able to outline the syntax of task management functions used in MuCOS 2. So let us have a look at the various syntaxes, which syntaxes we will cover in this video. First one, task. Second is syntax for task creation, means how to create the task. Second is, what is ideal task, its syntax, static task, and various task state. You know how many states are there? Acknowledge, there are 5 steps. So one by one we will cover which function we will call to go one if one task is running and we want to put that task in the dormant state, so which function we will call. We will study in this one by one. If we will cover that all the task related functions, so you will get to know which function is used for which state. Next is initialization of MuCOS 2 and starting of MuCOS 2. So let us discuss it one by one. Now task. So from earlier there are bitmost how many? 256 tasks. So how many tasks for MuCOS 2 related? 248 of which can be application task, and how many task is only used for MuCOS 2? That is how many? We can calculate 8 tasks are for MuCOS 2 and 248 tasks are for application. Each task has its own priority. You know the priority of every task in MuCOS 2 is different one. You cannot have same priority for 2 different tasks. So you will have to give, every task should have different priority. So if you will write 0, that means it is the task having highest priority. If you are using 4 tasks and one task number 3 is having 0 number, so that task will be treated as a higher priority task amongst all the 4. A task priority is also its identifier. Tasks are created using which one? Concentrate this line, OS task create. So OS capital, T capital and C capital, or OS task create extended. Now syntax of task creation. So this is OS task create. This is what syntax. So syntax consists of this one, pointer to file name, not file name, task name. This is pointer again for data, and it is stack size. You can observe task stack size is 16 bit unsigned integer, and this is task priority. So let's take simple example for this. We want to create a task of name task start. So you have to write OS task create in between this bracket. We have to pass how many arguments? 4 arguments. First one is pointer to task address. So this is what, pointer to task address. This is pointer to data that you want to pass to the task when it first start. So normally it is null pointer, but if you want to pass something to task, then you have to pass the pointer. Next is task top of stack. So this is called as TOS, top of stack. And last one should be its priority. So I have written here 0, means it should have highest priority task. Now syntax of extended task creation. Syntax is OS task create ext, and its format is OS task create ext, then first argument, you know, this is what about, this is pointer to file that task name, this is pointer data you want to pass stack, and this is what priority. This all was covered in the previous part. And next is integer 16-bit ID. So what ID contain? It establish a unique identifier for the task being created. That this identifier will allow to extend mucos to beyond its limit of 64 tasks. So we have discussed earlier, it is having 248 tasks. So this identifier will allow extend mucos to beyond the 64 tasks. For now, simply set the task ID to same value as the task priority. Next is OS stack PBOS. So it's a pointer to the stack bottom of stack BOS. Next is stack size. It is of 32 bit. So specify the stack. Specify the size of the stack in number of elements. This means that if a stack entry is 4 bytes wide, then stack size of 100 means that the stack will have 4000 bytes. Again, this argument is used for stack checking. Next is text. Text is a pointer to a user supplied data area that can be used to extend the OS task control block of the task. Next is INT 16. So it is unsigned 16 bit unsigned integer OPT. Specify the option to OS task create extended, whether the stack will be cleared, whether floating point operation are performed by the task or not. So for extended task creation, you should have, it is having how many extra arguments? It is having 5 extra arguments. So total argument consisting of extended task is 5 plus 4, that is 9. Now ideal task. So ideal task is what? That task will do, kernel always creates an that task will do continuously running. So kernel always creates an ideal task. So syntax is OS task ideal. Execute while no other tasks are executing. So means if there are two tasks and at this point if one task is running and after 10 seconds there are two tasks are running. So after 2 seconds, first task is over, then kernel will run this ideal task. So the task name is OS task ideal. So this is user defined, not user defined means user, this is already defined, predefined function. So if you are writing the code and you want to run a ideal task, so you can call this function. So it is always set to all, obviously its priority will be lowest priority. So always set to lowest priority, OS lowest priority. It will never be deleted by an application task, obviously. So what do you think? This task is of mucos 2 or it is application task? So find the answer and please write down in the comment box. So this task is of mucos 2 task or application specific task. It does nothing but increment the 32 bit counter value. So obviously task is, it is what, it is simple ideal task. So what it is doing, it is just incrementing a counter value. Next task is static task. The syntax is OS task stat. So to perform CPU usage computation, this task is very useful. Its priority is OS lowest priority 1. And this task is optional. Now we will jump to the dormant state. So various state there are, how many state? 5 state. So first one, dormant state. So the task reside in the program state but not been made available to the kernel. So this task is all present in the program space, the dormant state. Now if we want to move one running task or simple other task to the dormant state. So what you have to do, you have to delete that task. So you can delete the task by os task del. So by using this function you can delete the task. This will make task go to the dormant state. So to perform CPU uses computation, this task made available means if there are two tasks in the dormant state, so that task are available to the ready state by some function. So two functions are there, os task create and second one is os task create extended. So by using these two function you can move the task from dormant state to ready state. Now the next state is ready state. The task is ready to execute, the only thing is lacking in the CPU. This task is not running, this is ready state. So some task, some higher priority task is running. So after completing of that higher priority task, so next task will be run by this mucos to that task which is present in the ready state. Highest priority task is given the CPU running, okay, so by os start and return to the ready if it is preempted. Next state is interrupt service routine, ISR. So os int exit notifies mucos2 that an ISR is complete, that allows mucos2 to keep track of interrupt nesting. Os int exit is used in conjunction with os int enter. So interrupt enter and interrupt exit. So when the last nested interrupt completes, the os int exit determine if higher priority task is ready to run. If so, the interrupt return to the highest priority task instead of the interrupted task. Now os task sw, so that what does it mean? Sw means switch. So switch from lower priority task to higher priority task. So we can switch the priority of the task by using os task sw. So this is how ISR. Now next state is waiting state. So the task is suspended awaiting some event. So if you want if you want to use the shared resources, so that task should move to the waiting states. So the task is suspended awaiting some event, that is semaphore, mailbox or queue, or for some time to expire. And that task means that waiting task are moved to the ready state by some functions. You can imagine what function it is. So that function is related to some services. OS mbox, mailbox post. So you can move the task from waiting state to ready state by using this function OS mbox, mailbox post, os queue post front, os same post, os task resume, os time delay resume, os time tick. So these are all the functions to move from task from waiting state to the ready state. Now next point is initialization of mucos2. How mucos2 is initialized? So this is important. Os init, init. So this function must be called before any other services of kernel can be used. So this function must be called for initialization. So os init creates the ideal task which is already ready to run, and it creates the statistic task if it is enabled in the configuration file. So this function, what it will done? It will do ideal task to run or create the ideal task. OS init also create four pools of free data structure. for task control block, second is events, queues and memory. Next is starting of new cost. How it will get start? So you have to write OS start for multitasking. So it will start multitasking. At least one application task must be created prior to the starting multitasking. OS start find the OS task control blocks, OS TCB, of the highest priority task from the ready list. And OS start high ready is called, which restore the CPU register and execute and turn from interrupt instruction, which forces your task to run. So this is important function, OS start high ready. Now this function will run OS enter critical, OS exit critical, OS schedule lock, OS schedule unlock, OS version. So this is the starting of MeowCost 2, how MeowCost 2 is get started. So up till now we have discussed various points related to various syntaxes, that is task, syntax of task creation, idle task, static task, task state, initialization of task, initialization of MeowCost 2 and starting of MeowCost 2. So all these points are covered. Now let's move on to the next video.